Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Hogwarts Genesis. Now, it has been a hot minute since I last recorded an episode, but I have been doing some stuff in preparation in the meantime, such as getting our first build together. I think, like I said last time, I think I said that I was starting on Hagrid's Hut. So this is what I've got so far. I'm keeping the outside made of stone. So I've got an assortment of cobblestone, mossy stone, which I have, got like a large amount of supplies from the Forbidden Forest, and andesite as well, which, makes for a lovely sort of just rustic sort of texture. Inside is birch woods used from the chisel, and I've just been collecting some like materials, just getting things together. The chests are an absolute mess right now, except for this one, because I've limited this one to food, which should probably cook some up, because it looks like I'm going to die soon. Yeah, so I mean, apart from this, I haven't really done much. All of this has been done in survival. Let me just go into creative really quickly, and I'll just show you the shape of it. Hagrid's hut is very like rounded, and he's got like this little like extra like dip coming off of his house that goes more towards the Forbidden Forest. That's what I've done. I've stretched this bit out. I've like sort of leveled this area here so that we can do the pumpkin patch there. That is the one thing I am lacking in though at the moment is pumpkin patches. But surely we'll find some soon and we'll figure it all out. What else have I done? This is me trying to find pumpkin. I've found carrots and potatoes and wheat and everything else, just not pumpkin. So, I mean, what are you gonna do? I got melon as well, unfortunately. I got all of it, just no pumpkin. I made this thing, and I thought this was rather cool for when we start making like proper animal farms. Because I feel like in every Minecraft Let's Play, there is always that moment where someone goes out and they're like, let's go get some animals, because there are none here for some odd reason, right? And then they have to do the whole hold the carrot stick and then slowly walk, hoping that the animal will follow them. And then there's that moment where the animal loses interest, like every single time. This thing, check this out. It's on my head. So it's basically, it came with Tinker's Construct. It was two sticks and two leather, I think. What's it called again? Piggy. Yeah, two sticks and two leather, which I got the leather from, I have been defeating more Minotaurus. Is that the one that keeps, yeah, that's the one that keeps coming after me, and Harpies, because they spawn a lot. So I've gotten those all sourced from that. But yeah, I figured this would be a great way to move animals to whenever we make the farm, and then we can just drop them like that. So, I've started this little wheat farm over here because I was like, ugh, I'm dying all the time, I need bread. Unfortunately though, with the Pam's Harvest Craft mod, I need water. So, that's cool though, because I also do have, because of the magic forest beside us, we have a great source of mushrooms. So mushroom stew is usually on for dinner sometimes. But yeah, I've been mining, I've been building, I've been, thinking up of. So I went down here, making a bunch of like cobblestone sort of mines. This is like a proper mine that I haven't quite finished exploring yet, and then I just sort of dug out over here. I have a bed, I have, all sorts. So I figured, want to wear that. I do want you guys to let me know though, do you prefer this type of episode where I just show you what I've done in the meantime, or do you rather see more of the process as it goes along? Keep in mind though that I'm a very I would like to say an annoying builder because I'm so indecisive. Like, I'm happy with this. But to start off with, it was a lot of like, I forgot how to do like circular things in Minecraft. I started this off by doing like a wood sort of outline of what I wanted, and I was not happy with it, and it was a lot of like destroying and rebuilding, and then having to like go into creative so I could like quickly look at it, and it was a whole thing. So, but if you want to see it next time, just let me know and I'll make sure that happens. But I figured we could get into maybe some mods today. Mods or mining, I don't know, I'm not really sure. I feel like we really need to start Tickets Construct. Because we need the hammer for for all the like the stone and cobblestone we'll end up using on the castle, which is gonna be over here. I mean we do have mine colonies, but I feel like we don't have enough materials like to safely say that we can do that right now. We could even just start on like a magical mod. I don't know how to. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Is it these books? Do I like the Book of Shadows? So I would need to like. Well, why don't we? I think I've got those seeds, so why don't we grow them over there, and then we can start on something else. We can get into Tinker's Construct, so we're not doing like too much magical things at once. Was it Hellbore or was it Belladonna? This one. Hellbore. No. I'll just keep that in there for now. Grow it out later. Mandrake. And where is my. There it is. Okay. So we'll just grow these for now and then we can. I've got a sugarcane, so I'll plant those as well so we don't use it all up trying to make a book. There and there. Okay. So I'll plant the sugarcane and then we can start on the Tinker's Construct stuff. Which I've decided I want to live in the Forbidden Forest so that I'm not taking up space in the whole Harry Potter magical world, and I don't want to be like Hogsmeade wouldn't be towards the Forbidden Forest, like it's outside of that whole Hogwarts jurisdiction area, so I don't want to like I think I'm gonna put Hogsmeade across the river this way and then. Yeah, and then I will take like the Forbidden Forest as like my area so I can have like, you know, like a hut for my witchiness and all of that. So yeah. Just put that down for there for now. I don't usually play with Tinker's Construct is the thing though. I don't usually do it myself. Someone in like my friend group usually does it before I can. So it's going to be very interesting for me to do it. So I know I had a book, right? Like I started off with. Okay. So I know I need the smeltery for the smeltery is not saying blah blah blah, blah. It can be any size from a 3x3 to 11x11, any height. From a minimum of 2. Okay. Larger structures increase both the nanograms and the seconds per hour and the liquid capacity. The structure requires a floor. Okay. So I know that I need gravel, clay, and sand. Okay. So we need one of these, one of those. Right. Does this need to be like one level? All right, I'll just start on the easy one for now, right? Like that's the beginning. I'll just start on that for now. I think what we'll do is I'll make the like the wooden things. Where's oak wood there? But do I have it now? We'll just start on the wooden things to begin with, and then we'll so need some sticks. And then we need a crafting station. And I need that. And then I need one of these. But I also need a log of oak wood. And I'll just quickly come over here and grab one of those. Thinking that it can stop me. We've got quite a few bears in the area now, actually. I was like running through here at one point and they latched out and attacked me, so we're gonna have to be careful of all of the mobs. I think that's one of the reasons why I want to live in the Forbidden Forest, though, is because of the werecats, and I think the harpies spawn there pretty often too, but because of both of those, it should make for a really interesting area to spawn in, but also really rewarding too, because what, they occasionally drop like really special items or something. I don't know. I don't know anything about that mod really, except that it adds in creatures that are either passive or aggressive, and then that's it. All right, so I got those. I'm just gonna, for now, I'll just keep them in Hagrid's hut. Like, I know this is not his stuff. I'll just keep them here for now. Okay, so right, I'm just gonna go grab some like clay and sand and stuff like that. There's a little like sand mound, I wanna say. It's not like a hill, it's not an island, it's not, you know, it's just a little bit of like land that has come out from the ocean to the surface, but it doesn't have like any, like it has like one bit of grass on it with like a lime flower or something. So I've been, the sand that I have at the moment, I actually took from there, so I think that's what I'm gonna keep doing. I kind of just want to get rid of it. It doesn't seem to serve any purpose for me, so I think I want to actually live by that like lake there. I think it should allow for a nice like lake home. There's this one which we kind of ended up on in the first episode, but then there's also this one, which this is the island that I've been slowly but surely getting rid of. I think I'm really fortunate with the my spawn as well. Maybe I need to turn up my render distance. Yeah, I think I'll turn that up just a second. But over there is like really nice mountain ranges. Go 15 maybe. Hopefully that won't lag. Yeah, really nice mountain ranges. And the spruce wood forest, which is excellent, I think. That's very exciting. There's also a nice one over here with some like waterfalls and stuff. So that's pretty cool too. And over in that direction, like far over here, there is a swamp as well. So it's all very good, I think. I think we're very fortunate with where we spawned. Oh, there's more grass than I expected. Surprise, surprise. Yeah, but because we're so fortunate with our spawn, we are so lucky because we have so many different materials. I think the only thing that we don't have completely is a desert, but that might be another mound of sand that's like breached the water. So I don't know, maybe we are still lucky in that case. But we've got snow, we've got mountains. You know, easy access to pretty much everything that we need. So, I don't know, I think it's great. I like this area. So I'm pretty sure we need a lot, right? Because you'll want to build up your smeltery at some point and make it all like nice and pretty. Make it like Leaning Tower of Smeltery. Oops, okay. Okay, I'm gonna make another shovel. Oh, and I have died as well since you last saw me. But it was because I ended up killing those little creatures in mo creatures that throw blocks, not the ones that build themselves up using the blocks, but the ones that throw them. And it left a block just floating, and I tried everything I could to get rid of it. It just wasn't happening, so I was like, okay. And so I had to look it up to see how to get rid of it, and I figured it out, and so I did it, and I died. But I mean, I don't know if that really truly counts. Oh, it's so cute! Oh. And then this is your mum. Yeah. Oh. So cute. Do 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 raccoons. This is just a bountiful land. Very pretty. Bunny. Okay, so we are going to go make another shovel, and then I know where there's some gravel and some clay, so we'll get that. And then we'll make our. What is it called? Is it called? I want to say Groot, but I don't think that's right. Roo. Nope. No, it wasn't. Grout. I think that joke is the reason why I couldn't remember its name. Great. I am Grout. What am I looking for? Cobblestone. Some spikes. Shovelers. There we go. Some beautiful, beautiful shovelers. Alright. Stop it. Okay. So we'll head to the ocean. Oh well, we'll head to the this part of the river first, because I'm pretty sure I've seen some like good chunks of clay there. So we'll head there first. And then we'll hopefully get like a good amount of clay and good amount of gravel as well. So let's see. Oh, that's right. This has the Hang on, I'll see if this has any pumpkins. No pumpkins, please. No pumpkins. Like, we're getting everything else but pumpkins. They give me cauliflower. Cabbage. Cabbage. So here's some. Ooh. Yes, okay, thank you. Thank you, game. You have become well acquainted with the watery depths. I know there's like underwater breathing or something, or maybe when we're deciding on our animagus form, we can turn into a creature that lets us breathe underwater for long periods of time. I have killed quite a few mobs, but not just the bad ones. I like sometimes like I'd just be experimenting to see what the like the passive ones would drop. So I've killed a bird and like some crabs, and I feel so bad, but like that's how I got the crab meat, so I'm really fortunate to have the crab meat. Oh dear. Yeah. Because also I think that the it's kind of difficult to kill animals with the Animania mod as well. Well, like bulls at least, if you're not careful, because they'll attack back, right? Am I getting that information correctly? I'm not sure. I've never played with it before. I'll go back and we'll go to sleep, but I'm pretty sure there is some. What about the hill? Because the bloody griffin's there and it's gonna kick my ass. Ugh. All right, well, back home we go. So let's go back and continue with our collecting. And then hopefully we will make some. Jeez, that does not do a lot for me. Great. Just stop running around. I've only got 24. And I don't think it's like it's not an amount of it's just like one to a ratio of like to one to one, right? Like you just need one clay to one gravel and one sand, right? And that's how it. But still, like I know you need a lot because they just turn into bricks. But you need like the blocks, which is like four bricks, and so you'll need quite a lot of each thing to actually do the to do a good enough like build for it, I think. From what I remember is that's how it goes. Just wish you could like mine faster underwater. I know there's a oh my god, that scared me. That really scared me. I thought I was going to die. Wait, can I mine faster? Ooh, can I just like stay? No. What is okay. It's fine. I will just, do my best. No, come on. Go. Okay. I think there are some better deposits in the oceans. I'll go check those out. Ooh, hang on. There it is. One right here, which we can just dig into. Nice. Make sure the world still looks cute. Hashtag adorable world. So adorbs. Oh my gosh. Oh, that's pretty cool. I love the like the natural sort of formations Minecraft ends up doing. It's so great. And they're so like just fascinating as well, because you're like, wow, like, it's I think it's the same thing with like human civilization things, isn't it? Like how some people thought that, or some people think that, like the pyramids were placed down by aliens. And then from history we know that, the people would enslave others to build them. And so they're actually man-made rather than being like, but because they look so like, I don't know what's the word, like complete with the surroundings, it's like, is it actually man-made though, or is it, are we just trying to come like claim like ownership over it by saying that's a human thing rather than acknowledging that, it might be a man thing. I personally believe that it's a human thing. Because I'm pretty sure my history teachers would have a word with me about the my beliefs if they were otherwise. So I will stick to that. Oh no! But I still have the one in my. Yeah, we'll just get 104 of each, I think. We get 10 more gravel, and then we'll get a bunch more clay. So. But yeah, no, I love those sort of structures. I also think they just make for really awesome builds as well, because you can just sort of incorporate the structure into your build, which is always good. That's why Hagrid's hut has two levels in it. Even though I don't think he has it in actual Harry Potter. I don't know, I've just been looking at outside images to make sure that I get the outside of it like fully correct. But it's kind of interesting. But because the land is not flat, you know, I've added in that, you know, maybe he does actually have, like, he's got like little stairs in his home now, or as if it was, or it is, because playing it right now, it is two levels. So. Yeah, I like that aspect of Minecraft. It's like Minecraft. Minecraft's fun. It's I've been playing it since I was fairly young, actually. Round about when it first came out. Been playing it. It's just, you know, been something that stuck with me, and the people who played with it that I watched on YouTube have stuck with me since I was young as well. So I'm gonna have to fix this up. Is there some scrap, some of this dirt that doesn't look like it's needed? Let's just sort of fix that. There we go. Okay. So, what else? We need some more clay. We're getting some more. We weren't getting excuse me, sir. We weren't getting a lot of ocean-spawned animals last episode that I noticed. I haven't changed anything, but it looks like they've started to spawn in on their own, so that's pretty cool. It's pretty excellent. There you go. I murdered you. Here's some more clay. We'll just grab this. Hopefully, we don't attract the attention of any sharks. And I think that this should be enough. And then we'll have to pick out a spot for our smeltery. Which is that? Oh, yeah, that is enough. I obviously did not realize that I had that much. Okay. Yeah, so we'll go put this all together and we'll make, please don't attack me, snake and bear. We'll go put this together and then we'll see how many blocks we have, well, how many, bricks we have. And then we'll turn it into, I think it's a tank, the master controller, and something else. And then we'll make the rest of it into the like the block bricks. I don't know the other word for it. It's bricks, but it's, you know, the bigger ones, the better ones. That's the ones I'm talking about. Yes. Yes. Give me it all of it. Yes, okay. I'm not going to be cocky and say that that's probably enough, but I am glad that we have heaps. So now we'll also grow. Actually, I'm going to heal up first. I'm going to. There an easy thing I can do with like potatoes? I can make it into baked, obviously, but like something that I can just quickly salt. Oh, I think I have salt. Let me see. Because I have that baking thing. Oh crap. Right. Oh, it's right there in front of my face. Yay! Okay. I have salt. I will grab some potatoes. I'll grab them all. I have six. I will do three. And some of these mustard seeds, it said. And then we'll grab this bakeware and then we'll go into here. This, the salt, and nope. Hang on. What did I do wrong? Potato. Potato, potato. Oh. French fries? Oh, well, fries, but you know. How much is this gonna be? Just one. That's fine. We'll eat these three and then we'll heal up. And then we'll go grab the. If they're grown, the. The bewitchment stuff, because I don't know if you guys know, I don't think they actually hit you anything, they just made you nauseous, the mandrakes in witchery. But they would like spawn like actual mandrakes, which would not attempt to kill you, but. 42, 28. Okay, so not nearly done yet. Some wheat. Okay. I don't know. I guess we're just waiting. So, for that. What? Hang on. Oh, that is so gross. That would be so dry. I just ate wheat. Just wheat. What is wrong with you? Is that a thing? Do people do that? That seems odd. I've never seen that before. I guess we can make. Well, we can make the. Oh, Teddy Teddy Bosu! Oh, those are so cute. I made these ones. They're so cute. Teddy teddy bazoo. I guess we can make the Thorncraft book and the. No. Because Thorncraft is different in 1.12.2. I'm used to the old Thorncraft where you make the bookshelf and then you use the magic wand on it. But I think the Britannia book is still the same. You just put a book and a tree together, right? Where's the book? It's probably right in front of my face, but I can't see. Oh, that's right. I also have blood magic. I actually don't know how to start that. Is it the alchemy table? Is it like a book that helps you? I think this is also very exciting part of there it is of Minecraft is me. I don't know how to do these things, which is excellent. This is great. This is what dreams were made of. All right, so we'll grab the paper. Well, nope. Give me back my leather. Thank you. And then we'll make the. Is it still like this? Yes, the book. Okay, then we have the book. And now we have a sapling. And now we combine the two of them. We smash them together. And bada bing, bada boom, we have magic. Okay. So, yep. Cool. So, the Lexica Botania is the repository of all knowledge for all botanical matters, but you probably knew that already. All the information is stored here as expected for convenience. If a block happens to have an entry, it can be shift right clicked with the. Oh! I did not know that. So, if I went to one of the magical flowers, where are they? I know I saw some. I think. Because I've got Pam's wee flowers on here, there's a lot of like the. There's just a lot of normal Minecraft flowers. But if there's a. Wait, if I just. Oh, that is so cool. I did not know that you could do that before. Why didn't anyone tell me? Bumblebee, honey lady, honeybee, she's so cute. Is there no? I swear there's magical flowers somewhere. I swear I've seen them. But if I went like this, no, hang on, shift right click. Yeah, so it has to be something that's actually part of the mod. I swear, guys. I am not on magic shrooms, okay? I know that I said that the forest had good shrooms, but still. I know there's flowers somewhere around here. No, tiger, please. Please, I don't want to fight. There, right there, in front of my face. Purple ones. So if I'll go like this. Ah! Nice! I like that. That makes me happy. That's really cool. I didn't know you could do that before. That's really cool. What are you two doing? Bunnies? No, that's what I thought so. Run away from each other. We don't need you and your spawn army coming to attack us. Are you okay, Mr. Crow? Not Raven. Sorry. I'm not being intentionally specious, I swear. Okay, so, that's really cool. I didn't know you could do that. Are those some right out? Oh, okay. I went on a whole adventure for no reason, but because I could. All right, let me go back to. Any entries typed in italics are basic entries, which contain the very basic knowledge required to play Britannia and should be prioritized over others. Most of the sections contain one or more of such entries, so a good look through them is a good idea. That's how you make it. Title can be customized. Equates the version of the yep. And no, I don't care about the fourth wall. Appreciate it. And around the world, you may stumble upon a larger variety of mystical flora. Sweating these don't take much work as the flowers themselves emit a fair amount of shine. They come in different colors, and you can make them with a floral fertilizer. I know this from Overgrowth. These flowers can be plucked for mystical petals, which can be used for making magical instruments and plants alike. Right clicking the petal and you will bury it, having it emit particles. These petals can also be crushed into floral powder, doing that and that and that. Right clicking the floral powder on any wall or carpet changes the colors to the color of the you can make it a type of fertilizer. The floral fertilizer will make if you ever run low on them. So that's this. So it's like bone meal essentially, but with dyes. Oh, so you can use it with and there are taller ones which can be gathered with shears. Can be made manually by fertilizing a mystical flower or buried and you can but those give you multiple of yeah, thinking oh. If you find yourself running low on color, try burying a That's cool. I am happy with that. All right. I think I actually don't know how long I've been playing. So I think that I'm going to end the episode here with my centaur friend. Thank you all so much for watching. Next time, I'll hopefully have, depending on what you guys want, I'll hopefully have finished Hagrid's hut, or I will be gathering the materials and we can do it together. I don't know. We'll see. We'll find out together next time. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you like the content. Yeah. Bye.